professionally in the late 1990s, which was a long time ago in technology time. What I did was, at the time, I worked for MTV, and I was running a national voter registration campaign for MTV called Rock the Vote. And what we did was we went to college campuses and concerts, and we set up tables, and we registered people to vote at rock concerts and stuff like that. Very labor-intensive. Everywhere we wanted to register voters, we had to send volunteers and paperwork and tables and pens. It was really cumbersome. It was logistically difficult. Around that time, the internet became a big deal. And I figured out that you could actually eliminate all that extra work just by putting a voter registration website on the internet. So we created the first place on the internet where you could fill out a voter registration form electronically on your computer without having to ship out all those papers and all those volunteers and all of that extra effort and labor. In the year 2000, 700,000 Americans used that technology to register themselves to vote, to be able to participate in elections. The old-fashioned way of registering voters, it would have been impossible to register 700,000 people to vote. It would have been impossible. It would have just taken too much paper, too many people, too much work. All we did was write some code, Michael, just like you showed me. We wrote a little bit of code, we put it up on a server, we published it to the internet, 700,000 people used it. We didn't have to lift another finger. That's incredibly powerful technology. And technology like that has changed everything about society in the 15 years since I first started working with it. Almost everything we do is different, except in the education system. For the most part, we still do things the way we've done them for over 100 years. In the education system, we're still using paper. We're still very labor intensive. We're still very old fashioned about it, which is why I'm very excited to see the way you guys are learning here. Not just because you're using technology, but because technology is enabling you to work in groups, to develop problem solving skills, to do the things that in the 21st century workforce you really actually have to know how to do. And things that don't get measured on the tax test or the STAR test or whatever test. Things that are really difficult to measure, but things that matter a lot. The skills you're using here matter a lot. So in the legislature, one area where we've made some progress is we've let schools use the money they used to only be allowed to use on textbooks. We said they can use it on any instructional materials, computers, software, any iPads, whatever, is useful to give you the information and the tools you need to learn. So I think it's super cool that you guys aren't just using computers to learn, you know, how to surf the internet. You're learning how to create the internet. That's really cool. And I really believe that in 10 years, if you keep with it, when you finish your education, you will have enormous opportunities because all these grown-ups around you don't know the first thing about how to do what you're doing. Michael explained it to me 10 or 15 times. I still don't understand it. It is because it is alien to us. It is foreign to us. When you guys are 25 years old, you're going to be putting us all out to pasture because you're going to know so much that we don't know about the most essential things people have to know in the workforce. So stick with it. Please stick with it. You guys have real talent. You're better at this than we are. It's cool when young people know more than the old people in the room. I guarantee you the opportunities that will be available to you from working with this kind of technology are limitless. So thank you for your hard work on it, and thank you again for inviting me.
Made possible by our sponsors, A and B. They have a big event. employ a lot of people in Austin, but they also support education in Austin. So can we give them a round of applause, too?